This is artist and photographer Jim Turlington. And, you know, I thought I'd do a little video here because I've had some people ask me about what's the story behind this rooster painting. Well, I'll tell you what the story is on this painting. Back in June of 2019, I was doing a little promotional art tour around Central Florida, promoting my artwork and photography. And one of the places that I had to go to was their office is out in the country, and it's a rural office. And so I stopped, I went in, and I noticed they had a bunch of roosters that were running around on the property. So I stopped, I went in, I talked to them, left some promotional material there. When I came out and I was walking back to my truck, I crossed paths with this real barnyard brawler of a rooster, real tough guy, who decided he was going to stand his ground. I mean, he flared his wings out, he got his head real low, the feathers on the back of his neck were standing up. So, you could tell, you know, he was letting me know this was his territory. So, I've been around a lot of roosters. I've had roosters before. My dad had roosters, so I've dealt with a lot of roosters over the years. So I just decided to stand there for a second, kind of let him calm down. So eventually I started to go around him, and you know, he was giving me like the evil eye watching me the whole time, and I was giving him the evil eye watching him to make sure he didn't make a sudden charge on me and try to spur me, you know. So I went over to my truck, and I got my camera out of my camera bag, and I took two or three pictures of him. One of the pictures, you know, turns out it had a really interesting shadow on the bottom, but I didn't know that until after I got back home and I put it on a computer where I could see it a little better. Well, I was so impressed with the tenacity of this bird. I've actually laughed about it several times when I tell this story to people, you know, that I just decided I was going to paint this bird. So I did a 16 by 20 acrylic painting on stretch canvas. And after I did it, the first thing I did was I just took a picture of the rooster painting. And I put it on social media, and people liked it and everything. And I got a good response back from it. Well, then I decided, one day I had been doing some other stuff, and I had some blue farm overalls on. And I had the same shirt on. It's a shirt I bought. It's a clay-colored shirt that I bought up in Tallahassee whenever I was up there on a visit. And I had the overalls on and this shirt, and I put this necklace on that I made from a couple of years ago from a oyster shell that came from Apalachicola Bay up in North Florida. And so I went outside, and I was standing outside on my property taking some pictures. And whenever I set the timer to hold the painting and take one of the pictures, I noticed there was some real tall grass growing there next to me. So I reached over and I pulled one up, broke one of them off, pulled it up, stuck it in the corner of my mouth, and it's kind of like hanging out of the corner of my mouth like this, you know. And I took a picture of it. Well, when I took that picture and I put it on social media, everybody had a good laugh with it. They loved it. Some of my friends who know me, who've known me for a long time, have even called it the Hayseed Jim photograph, you know, which doesn't bother me because, you know, I'm a guy who's lived in the country the vast majority of my life. I'm not a city slicker, you know, so it doesn't bother me. You know, I've had fun with it as well, you know. So, I was doing some other stuff, and one day I showed the picture to a lady who's, she's the editor of Backyard Poultry Magazine. And I showed her, you know, pictures of me with the painting. And I told her about the story behind it, and she loved it. And she wanted to know if she could put, if I would write up a little article about it, and she would put it in the magazine. Well, I did, and I sent her the photo, and she put it in the March 2019 issue of Backyard Poultry Magazine. In fact, if you look above the painting, right there it is, right there, you know. And I'll show you a better close-up view of it here in a minute. But everybody's had a lot of fun with this mania. I've had a lot of fun with it. I've had a number of people ask me if I would sell it, but I'm really not interested in selling it. Most of the time, I just keep it up here on the wall with, above a little sign I've got up here that's a little miniature replica of a historic Route 66 sign out in Missouri, because my mother was from Missouri, my older sister lives in Missouri and was born there, my younger sister Gail was born there, and so I lived out there for a while whenever I was younger. So I just decided to hang it above that, you know, and it seems to go pretty well. It's kind of like the why'd the chicken cross the road thing, and I tell people to get on the, why'd the rooster cross the road, I told them to get on the other side of Route 66. So that's kind of the story behind the rooster painting, and everybody has a lot of fun, has had a lot of fun with it, so have I, and that's really how I painted it and why I painted it. So thanks for watching, I appreciate it, and have a good day. So long.